Well, holy flying cylinders, guys. We got some exciting news from Rocket Lab today. They just released some new pictures showing some new designs of their Neutron rocket. I did think their design was pretty much set in stone, but evidently not. Peter Beck and the engineers have been at it this whole time, making tweaks and updates. So I just wanted to take a look at these new changes to Neutron with you guys, share my thoughts, and talk about potential implications of these changes. Before we do that, though, if you haven't subscribed already, I hope you'll do that by the end of the video, and every like and comment always helps out as well. Thanks so much. With that out of the way, let's take a look at what was just unveiled for Rocket Lab's Neutron. Okay, so first of all, let's just look at some cool new pictures of the Neutron. I'll show them to you one by one. Once that's done, we'll look at them side by side with the old ones and really go into what's changed and why this could be a pretty big deal. First off, really cool here, we see Neutron up in space releasing a constellation of satellites into orbit. Usually, in previous renderings of the Neutron, it would just be one big satellite, but I think they're really trying to show here that this is a good vehicle for releasing constellations and launching constellations. Cool one of Neutron in the sky. I thought it would be a little hard to tell whether this was going up or coming down, because of course that fairing on top stays attached the entire way up and down. It just opens and then closes again. But I think we can safely say this is going up because of the rocket engines down below. It does look like they're all lit, whereas I think if it was coming back in for a landing, we'd probably only see one or a few engines lit. Pretty cool picture, though. I love it. Well done to whoever the graphic designer artist was who did this render. A new one in space, again, showing just the two mouths opening instead of the four-piece fairing that we used to have. A cool angle, and body looks to be a bit smoother. And this one is obviously not a constellation like that previous shot. Finally, we just have Neutron standing tall on the launch pad here. You don't see a lot of infrastructure because they're trying to keep the launch pad as minimal as possible, reduce the costs around the infrastructure, which is obviously a very important part of the rocket. Fueling everything from below instead of attaching from above, I understand. Okay, so now on to the important stuff, looking at how these two designs compare. First of all, I just wanted to confirm on the specs that there's no major changes here, and indeed, height diameter, fairing diameter, payload to LEO, liftoff mass, propellant, all the exact same. So all the specs still the exact same here, no major change, just kind of the appearance and some of the more granular capabilities are a little bit different. So first off, just the two rockets standing on the launch pad side by side. Sorry, this was just how I cropped them. They should be the exact same height. So if the one on the right looks bigger, that was just my fault. But basically what I wanted to point out here, a few different changes. First of all, this whole section used to be the fairing on the first rocket. On the upper stage, and this whole thing would open up into two pieces as we saw in some of those previous pictures. But it's quite a bit larger than the fairing on the new Neutron. So I do kind of like this, because if you have this whole section opening, like that's a big opening you need to make sure seals properly, and I feel like it just adds some complexity. By the way, guys, I'm giving you my opinion on this rocket, but I am by no means a rocket engineer, and I don't claim to be an expert, so just one man's opinion. I think it probably makes sense to keep the moving parts as small as possible, keep the opening smaller if it can be. And I do think the payload size, the payload volume will be the exact same, which means even though the opening only goes to here, I feel like the payload probably is still going down to somewhere like here on the inside. That part just doesn't open, whereas the full thing opened on the previous rendering at least. So I think this is a clever design. Perhaps it would make it a little more tricky to have one of those large oversized fairings like we've seen in other rockets, where it would kind of like stick out, extra large if you have a larger payload. But I think it's a pretty clever design overall, no problems with it. These little surfaces going up, I assume, are for aerodynamic reasons as well. They look very sharp, literally, and in terms of looking cool. And the landing legs are another big change here. So we can see at the bottom how the landing legs kind of just extended almost straight down from the rocket. And now this was because the rocket was so wide, it was felt that they didn't need fold-out legs like, say, a Falcon 9 has. That's changed now. Now, also, of course, the rocket looks a little bit more thinner, a little bit less, you know, traffic cone shaped and more like a traditional rocket you would expect from, say, a Falcon 9 or someone else. So a little bit thinner, still the same mass and payload. And obviously these landing legs are now fold out legs, more like you would see in a Falcon 9. Let's watch a couple clips here. The first one is going to be from an animator on YouTube, Heza Greyard, if you want to check him out. He did this render of Neutron. It's really great. This is the old style landing legs. Let's take a look at how it works. Okay, pretty straightforward there, just coming down on the legs, and they're really more absorbing the shock than anything else. They did not have to kind of stabilize and stick out wider because of the width of the rocket. I think there was a lot of concerns around these legs in terms of the heat of coming back into orbit, though, because they're not folded up. They would probably have to handle a lot of heat, and maybe that could cause problems. I wonder if that had an impact on deciding to go with the new design. Let's take a look at a Falcon 9 landing, which is what this looks like it's going to be very similar to. Let's take a look. So as you can see there, those legs folded out and landed. They provide more stability by sticking out even further than the width of the rocket, which is necessary if the rocket is thin and long like a Falcon 9 is versus that previous version of the Neutron. This Neutron still kind of in the middle, still thicker than, say, a Falcon 9, but not really quite as pronounced in terms of the disparity between the width of the top and the bottom of the rocket. Next one, just showing side by side these two releasing payloads into orbit. We can see they used to have four pieces. This change was not actually new. It was announced a while ago, but they hadn't actually updated any of the media on the site until just now. Cool shot, and we can see the body of the rocket looking a little more straight and slim than this old rocket, where it looks like it kind of bows out in the end. Also, the second stage here, it does look a little bit more like, say, a pop can, and as opposed to like a taper here. I feel like we've got a bit of a taper going on in this section, whereas this, it's almost flat. It looks a little sturdier to me, to be honest, the new version. So no problems with that one, in my opinion. Looks more real, almost. Final side-by-side, releasing payloads. Again, that upper stage, we can see a little bit of a difference. I think I like the new one better in terms of appearance. It's still very minimalistic, trying to be as small as possible in terms of mass to payload. Big fan of it. And they are showing off that they're releasing a constellation as opposed to just one large satellite. So that's it for the pictures we got and the new updates to Neutron. Pretty exciting. Overall, I do think I like the new design. I think it looks pretty cool. Although I do have to say that the old design did have something of an eye-catching look to it when you look over. It's so unusual having that very wide base and that thin top. Really made people stop and pay attention to it. This one looking a lot more standard like other rockets, which I'm okay with. I mean, it's been done this way in the past for a reason. It still is thicker and shorter than a lot of other rockets, like, say, a Falcon 9, which I feel like means maybe there's room for it to get stretched out and go even bigger if there's a demand for it. Don't forget, many rockets, as they go through different versions, do get more powerful. Even Electron was able to increase its payload to orbit, its mass to orbit, and Falcon 9 went through many block versions where they stretched out, got bigger, were able to deliver more mass. So there's every reason to believe that Neutron could be continued to stretch out and become even more capable in the future if the company feels like the demand is there. I'm sure in the near future we're going to get another interview from Peter Beck or some of the other guys at Rocket Lab, and they will be asked about these differences and we'll get some more details. Definitely looking forward to that. I'll see you guys in the next video. This one was just quick. I really just wanted to get out and talk about these changes right as I saw them. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a great day. Bye for now.